My name is Michaela Cole and I have just picked up Breakthrough Award.
What does it mean for you to be holding that award in your hand?
It was a breaking forth indeed. Chewing gum is my baby, it's my child. It was the hardest thing I've ever done, so it means a lot. It's crazy that I've actually won this. I was alongside a lot of great people, DC Moore, who wrote Not Safe for Work, who I absolutely love. This is crazy, but lovely. I wrote it. It was a play first that I wrote. It's a lot to do with my real life and my background and friends who I've went to school with. And it's kind of like my soul. I kind of put everything into it, as I think most writers do. So it's incredibly dear to me, yeah.
Why is it so important to have nights like tonight that celebrate the people behind the camera as well as in front?
Oh, yeah, I think it's vital. I think especially because, the British public only see the faces and they don't think about who lit that, what's on the screen, who designed that interior? It's amazing. And I do think it's important for them to know that really actors, the actors are great, but we're just in the wheel, and it's a big wheel. And without all these people, set designers, writers, this can't happen. So, yeah. What's coming up for me next? Season 2 of Chewing Gum. I think that's about it for now. Yeah. We'll see. A couple of things coming out.
What can we expect from season 2?
More of the same awkward sex and lovely relationships and community vibe on an estate. More of the same, I hope. Yeah.
I'm Ben Brown. I won Best Factual Editing.
What was the biggest challenge you faced on that particular production in order to produce the work that has won you this beautiful award tonight?
Probably trying to make it what they hoped it would be. They wanted to have a certain feel about it. They wanted it to have a certain dramatic feel, and that was how they conceived it and filmed it. But then that has challenges in the edit, because obviously it's not a drama. It's a documentary, so then making sure that it had all the right parts and components that a documentary should have, and had the warmth and the heart that real things often have.
And how important do you feel nights like tonight are that celebrate the achievements of people working in the industry behind the camera, not just in front?
No, I mean, it's great. It's absolutely, it's a brilliant night. I can't answer that one. Sorry, it's a good night.
My name's David Blackmore, and I've just won the award for editing fiction for Wolf Hall.
How does it feel to officially now be a BAFTA winner?
It's wonderful. It's really great. Yeah, Wolf Hall has brought a number of nominations, including an Emmy, but this is the first one where I've actually got an award, so it's very good. Well, it was a wonderful book turned into a great script, but we had a wealth of material, and some of it had to, fall by the wayside when we were getting it down to length. So there were a lot of difficult decisions, but in the end, it came together as it did, and we were really pleased with the results.
And as a BAFTA-winning editor, what is the essence of good editing?
I think it's just making the most of the material that you've got. I liken myself to being like a midwife, that the life is there and my responsibility is to bring it to the screen. And when you're working on something like Wolf Hall, where you've got so many good performances, it's an absolute joy to be able to do that.
Looking back, is there a particular episode or sequence that you're most proud of with Wolf Hall?
Well, there is a number. I think the one that will linger always in my mind is the end of the last episode, where Anne Boleyn is executed and Cromwell is welcomed by Henry VIII and embraced by him. And it is really shocking. There's something about that execution that plays out in pretty much real time that is shocking in a sort of way that is really visceral. And then when Cromwell is embraced by Henry, it's like he's got to the center of the spider's web, and you realize what the result is of his deal with power. He's become the second most powerful man in the country, but he's in the most dangerous position possible. Well, after that, I did an adaptation of a Joseph Conrad novel called The Secret Agent, and that will probably be going out on BBC One, I think, in the autumn. And I'm currently working on an adaptation of a Len Deighton novel called SSGB. Just do as much as you can by way of filmmaking. It's much easier now with all the lightweight technology, mobile phone cameras, everything can give you the opportunity to make short films on the cheap, and there's no restriction on your creativity. So I would say do as much as you can, be as imaginative and creative as you can before getting bogged down in sort of bigger constraints of budget and technology and that sort of thing. Just have fun and explore and see what the joys are of filmmaking, and then that will, I think if you really like that, that'll give you a taste that'll take you on into bigger and better things.
My name's Stephen Price, and I was in original music score.
And what does it mean for you now officially to be a BAFTA award winner?
Oh, it's thrilling. It's great. I certainly didn't expect that tonight. So it's, it's made for a wonderful night. Thank you.
And what was it that inspired this BAFTA award-winning score?
Oh, the whole programme was a gift. It was like 6-7 episodes of amazing photography and great stories, and I literally just got to start a new sequence every couple of days for 6 months. It was a fantastic job. I never watched anything I've finished ever, but I remember various sequences of, there was a sequence with the blue whale in the film where it was just a huge sweeping sequence, went on for 5 or 6 minutes and the music got to build and build, and it's just a rare opportunity to sort of unleash that sort of thing. It was great to do.
How much of a challenge is it to find music that can match the grandeur of images like that?
Oh, it's the pictures kind of tell you what to do, really. So it was a challenge, but it was a lovely challenge. It was a really rewarding sort of thing to do. Every day was a different adventure, so it was a nice, fun project to do.
I'm Will Cohen from Milk Visual Effects, and we've just won for the Special Visual and Graphic Effects category at BAFTA Craft.
And I'm Jean-Claude Deguara for Milk Visual Effects for Jonathan Strange.
What does it mean to you guys to now officially be BAFTA winners?
It's amazing. It really is. It's such an honour to be up against such strong nominees for this, so we're really happy to get this.
We have started a company less than 3 years ago, and this is our third year on the trot winning this prize in the category, which for me is a fairy tale, and we're very lucky. I'm particularly happy about Jonathan Strange because we worked so hard on that. It was a work of massive passion. I was inspired by JC, the whole team were, and I think it's a beautiful bit of work. I look at it and I'm so proud of it. So I'm really glad that it carried a prize back from this evening. It's really good stuff.
I'm Nick Benz. This is Mickey Cato. Company is studio is Momoko, and we won for Fortitude. Title sequence.
Extremely happy. We are nominated 4 times before, and finally we won.
What do you think it was about this particular production that meant that you did finally win this year?
Maybe it was because we didn't have to introduce characters so much, that it was more of an emotional, abstract piece, and the audience could read more elements into it.
Why do you think that nights like tonight are so important, celebrating achievement behind the camera, not just in front?
Well, like many industries, there's so much time spent late nights it's just wonderful to have some kind of acknowledgement. And for titles especially, there aren't really many awards. It's wonderful to be out there.
Yes. I think it set up the tones for the actual drama. So actually really supporting well and representing the drama story itself, it's the best titles.
And it brings the audience.
Brings audience into the world.
Yeah.
The award is Sound Factual, and it was VE Day 70, 70th anniversary of VE Day, for BBC Events.
What does it feel like to be officially now a BAFTA award winner?
It's fantastic and very unexpected, to be honest. Great privilege.
For you, what were the biggest challenges you faced working on this particular production from a sound point of view?
I think it was just the unexpected nature of everything that happens on a live broadcast like that. You never know what's going to happen. You have a fantastic team of people that work with you that you hope will deliver whatever happens. But it's all unexpected, and you just react to what's going on, really.
And in terms of that team, how many people are responsible for the results that we see on screen?
We probably had about a team of about 30 or 40 sound people that were working over the various OBs around that weekend for VE Day. They're all doing different sections of the programme, but it all came together in the OB in Hyde Park that pulled all those events together to present what the viewers saw at home.
How important do you think it is to have nights like tonight that celebrate the achievements of those people?
We don't very often get to say to each other how well we've done and, you know, to celebrate the craft of television and its sound in particular. It's nice to actually sit down and give ourselves a pat on the back, and that's why these sort of events are really important.
Why do you think that the UK television industry seems to be leading the way in so many different categories globally?
Well, that's a very interesting question. I don't know. I think there's I think there is a long history with it, actually, that has carried on a sense of excellence down through the generations and that kind of expectation. It's inbred to us in many ways, but I don't know. I think that's it, really. It's generation after generation that have passed it down. High standards are expected. That's what we go for.
This is Fatini Dimu. I've just won costume design for The Dresser, directed by Richard Eyre, Playground Productions. It has to do with my life in the theatre, because I've designed a lot of theatre productions and a lot of Shakespeare productions. So my past life has been in the theatre for a very, very long time, and especially Shakespeare's being a veteran of the Royal Shakespeare Company. So this was my inspiration, the knowledge of that world. And then, of course, the two major actors, Ian McKellen and Anthony Hopkins, and the way they interpreted their parts and my collaboration with them, and the most extraordinary brief from my director, Richard Eyre, who gave me the opportunity. He's also a theatre director, and he's inspired me tremendously in this. He knows that we're part of the same world.
My name's David Roger, and I got the award for designing Jonathan Strange and Mr. Norrell, drama series on BBC.
And what was it that inspired your particular design work on that?
Well, the fact that it was about magicians in early Georgian England meant I could really use my own imagination because I could invent most of it, actually. So it all came out of my head, I must admit. I think it was this thing that we got all these palaces, and we grew trees through the floor and through the windows. We made nature sort of take over civilization. So we had to build all these trees that looked like they were coming through windows and floors without actually smashing holes in the wall. And it was quite tricky, but it was great fun to do, and I'm quite pleased with that.
And how pleased are you to have nights like tonight that celebrate achievement in the industry behind the camera as well as in front?
Oh, well, I'm all for it, of course. Yeah. I think, because the first thing people register is what they register with their eyes, I think. So it is nice that the design side of it is recognised like this, and we get presents as well as the actors.
What are you working on at the moment?
I'm not, because it's not been greenlit till next week, I'm not really allowed to tell you. Is that a problem? you're not really allowed to mention projects until they're greenlit. The last thing I did was called The Secret Agent by Joseph Conrad. I can mention that because it hasn't been shown yet, but that is coming onto your screens soon.
We just were lucky enough to win for digital creativity for the Humans campaign for Channel 4.
What does it feel like to be a BAFTA winner?
Surprisingly awesome. We didn't think we were going to win, so it was it's a great surprise. And yeah, I'm feeling quite pretty chuffed right now.
Yeah, quite emotional. I just keep giggling. I don't know. I keep smiling. I need to stop smiling so much because it's not good for you. It was different to a traditional marketing campaign in that really we didn't sell the show off the bat. Basically what we did was we got people to buy into the themes of AI and what that could mean for humanity. And then gave people a destination to find out what we were talking about, which was essentially the show. And then in that way, it was quite different to a normal marketing campaign. I think that was the biggest challenge, getting people to buy into this idea of not having any logo, not telling people what it was on initially, driving the buzz, driving the talk, and then pushing people to the show after that.
I think it sort of tapped into all of those things that that hit our everyday life. You know, we use technology a lot. Technology has become a sort of something that we turn to for communication, for comfort, for news, for guidance. And I think it felt like a very easy thing that slips into our life. And so the drama tapped into all of those fears and dreams and ambitions. And I think it was a great idea that slipped very easy into day-to-day life, which I think was half of its success. And along with the dramatic kind of storyline was awesome.
My name's Laurie Rose, and I've just won the photography and lighting in fiction BAFTA.
How does it feel to be a BAFTA award winner?
It's blown my head off. I'm massively speechless, really. It's something that I never felt really quite possible. I didn't feel in the realm of these things, and there it is. So it's very exciting, speechless.
How exciting is it to have nights like tonight that celebrate achievement throughout all areas of the industry?
I think having a craft section of any awards is critical, really. I think it's not... There's a public face of best programmes and actors and everything, and that's great. And it should happen, of course. But I think it's not just about that. Lots and lots of people make programs and make films, and I think everybody deserves recognition for that. And so I think that having a craft award is critical. It's important.
And aside from giving you a BAFTA, what are you most proud of looking back on this particular piece of work?
This was a very bold piece of work. I'm very proud of it. It was done quite quickly, and I think it was done with a lot of energy and a lot of passion in the end. Fantastic acting, fantastic direction, and that just gave me the opportunity to gave me a lot of liberty and a lot of pushed me to being bold and taking risks, which I think is what made it a bit special.
Is there a particular risk that you were most nervous about taking?
It was the amount that we had to do, I think, in quite a short space of time. That, and just getting that done and moving, covering lots of ground and doing lots of moving about, trying to make London look interesting and different. You know, it's not difficult particularly, but it wasn't your ordinary London. It was a slightly darker side of London, hopefully, and that's that came out in the show.
What are you working on next? What are you working on at the moment?
I've just finished a film with Paddy Considine. Paddy Considine's second directing film, and I'm having lots of meetings right now, so hopefully something's going to come off very soon.
I'm Jamie McPherson, cameraman, and we just won Best Photography Factual.
How does it feel officially to be BAFTA Award winners?
Obviously, absolutely amazing. On behalf of the whole team, I think we're all totally delighted.
Chuffed a bit.
Yeah, really cool.
Why is it so important to have nights like tonight that celebrate achievement in all areas of the industry?
Because without everybody doing what they do, you know, we wouldn't be here. It's everyone. It's not just, you know, it's the whole lot.
Yeah, it's a team effort.
We couldn't do it without the production, the amazing production people back in the office who are actually so undersung. They're incredible, and they're the ones who should be really here. Well, kind of.
I think this production was all about pushing the photography forward, the wildlife photography forward. We took cameras and put them on different vehicles, stuck them in different places underwater. You know, just it felt like it was a paradigm shift in what we were doing, and I think it showed on the screen.
We've won for sound fiction, and it was for Wolf Hall.
And how does it feel to now officially be BAFTA Award winners?
On behalf of everybody else, I think I'm saying this is the truth. It's not quite sunk in yet. We feel amazing. We're just bubbling, buzzing. That's what it feels like.
What were the specific challenges and rewards of working on this particular show?
Keeping kind of stillness and silence alive, really. You know, it's a very, very quiet show, but there's a lot going on. There's a lot being considered every scene. So that was lovely, you know.
I think the execution scene at the end of episode 6 is a thing we're all very, very proud of, you know, that to have, I mean, it's about 7 or 8 minutes of almost complete sort of stillness, and you can really feel, you know, Claire Foy's brilliant performance there. She's absolutely brilliant, and you can feel her fear and at the same time trying to be strong, you know, and it's... But you know, all of it, and we were helped by such a wonderful score as well from Debbie. I think it just really underpinned everything, all the work we did. So yeah, we're very happy and very, very proud.
I think the thing about nights like tonight is that the general public don't really see what goes on behind the scenes an awful lot. They maybe don't actually understand how we do the things that we do. And also, you know, we want to encourage people to come and do this. We want to encourage people to come and work in our industry in all the different fields. So when you get a night like tonight and you see people picking up the awards and you get the excerpts from pieces of work, I think that possibly that's a good shop front for the industry.